this video, I'm going to talk a little bit about honeybee collection, processing, storage, and utilization of pollen. We all know that honeybees collect pollen. A lot of people in the general public, this is a little bit foreign to them. They might know that bees visit flowers and help flowers get pollinated, but they may think that bees are doing that because of sheer benevolence. They just want to go out and help plants like all the plants around me. But in reality, honeybees and other bees, for that matter, collect pollen to consume pollen. They have a purpose for that pollen. I'm going to talk a little bit about that process from A all the way to Z about honeybee interactions with pollen. First, let's look at honeybee anatomy. Honeybees are covered in hairs that if you pluck off and look under a microscope, we'll notice they are branched. Our hairs under a microscope are just straight shafts, but honeybee hair has that straight shaft with branches coming off in both directions. So when a honeybee is working a flower, those branched hairs are actually collecting pollen that's on that flower and they're getting stuck on the bee's body. The bee also has special parts on its legs to allow it to comb that pollen from its body, at which point it will moisten it with nectar and stick it on its hind leg, which is where they put it into the very famous pollen basket. The pollen basket is really just a row of hairs on both hind legs that the bees can pack that pollen into. Those rows of hairs hold that pollen and allow bees to transport it back to the nest. One of the interesting things about bees is while they're flying to flowers for the purpose of pollen collection, they are actually building up an electrostatic charge that is opposite of that of the pollen grains on the flower. So if you've ever seen slow motion videos of the bee coming in and landing on the flower and pollen literally jumping off of the anthers of the flower and onto the body of the bee, it's really amazing. Remember, I've mentioned that bees will moisten that pollen with nectar to transport it back to the hive. When they do that, they are also adding enzymes. Sometimes it'll be honey, sometimes nectar, but always enzymes are included, and that starts the processing of that pollen. So that forager bee will fly it back to the nest, and when she's at the nest, she goes to the area of the hive that they store pollen, and they look for empty cells. And when they find an empty cell, they'll back up their hind legs to that cell and push off those pollen balls. And the forager from that point goes back out to collect more pollen, comes back in to repeat the process. We're gonna leave her alone and focus in now specifically on that pollen that's been deposited into those cells. Once in the cells, another cohort of worker bees, the pollen handlers, will come and process that pollen further. They will add more nectar or honey, additional enzymes, and all of these things help process the pollen. What is that processing and why is it important? Well, that process is actually something that encourages lactic acid fermentation of the pollen. If you think back to nectar, bees collect nectar and have to store it in cells. Well, nectar is too wet. Bees have to dry off that water. And by virtue of drying off that water, they concentrate the food source, same amount of energy, but less space, which means they can extend the shelf life of that nectar and also make it where they don't have to store so much nectar all over the nest because they've concentrated that same amount of energy into honey. Well, think about bee bread somewhat similarly, in that the bees are processing pollen into bee bread for the purpose of extending its shelf life as well as increase its nutritive properties. Bee bread then is a type of fermented pollen. It contains a lot of nectar, enzymes, other secretions the bees put in there. And once that pollen handler has packed that pollen into the cell and the cell is 3/4 of the way full, another bee will come in and put a thin layer of honey over the top. And what that does, it seals that pollen in that cell with a layer of honey, and it starts that lactic acid fermentation. There are nutritive changes undergoing in that pollen as it transitions from pollen to bee bread, and it actually makes it something bees can benefit from eating even more. It extends the shelf life even more. And another thing that lactic acid fermentation will do, this processing, this enzymatic processing with these lactic acid bacteria, is that it will take pollen that's encapsulated in a very hard shell and it will break open a lot of those shells to facilitate digestion when the worker bees ultimately consume that pollen. So that's how they collect it, that's how they process it. So where in the nest do they put it? Well, if you think about honeybee nests as cylinders rather than cubes, I always think that the brood area is roughly the shape of a squashed basketball. Think about the frames in the middle, you'll get this big oval pattern, and as you move to the combs away from that one in the middle, you get smaller and smaller oval patterns. But if you were to excise out the brood, you would get something that's roughly the shape of a squashed basketball. Well, pollen, or bee bread, is important for the production of brood. If you think about that brood area as that squashed basketball, a kind of spherical, then pollen is stored as a jacket on the upper half of that brood. So think about that brood and now paint the upper half a couple of centimeters, maybe an inch thick with a layer of pollen. So if you were to take out a comb, a single comb, it would look very two-dimensional. You've got this circular pattern of brood, and over the top of that brood, you have a small rainbow of pollen. That's where in the nest bees store pollen and where that pollen undergoes that lactic acid fermentation to become bee bread. They put it close to the brood. How do bees use it? Well, pollen is a protein, vitamin, mineral, nutrient, and lipid source for honeybees. They consume it. When an adult bee emerges from her cell, the worker bee, she will consume lots of pollen, with that peaking around day 5 or 6. And while they're consuming that pollen, it is further developing the glands in the bees' heads that produces the brood food. So the mandibular glands and the hypopharyngeal glands. Those worker bees, those young worker bees, consume lots of bee bread to develop those glands to make it possible for them to produce brood food. That's why when worker bees are instantly coming out of the cells, they're not ready to feed larvae. Give them 5 days or a week when they're consuming that bee bread, those glands are developed, and now they can transition to being nurse bees because they're capable of producing brood food. So bee bread helps young adult bees mature and develop further, specifically those glands in the head to make it possible for them to produce food for all the offspring in the nest. Thinking specifically about larval diet, the first few days of larval diet, it's exclusively royal jelly. Then workers and drones, those larvae that are destined to be workers or drones, get that transition diet to what we would call brood food. The queen larvae remain feeding on royal jelly, but those workers and drones transition to brood food. In those later stage development of the worker and drone larvae, that's when the bees are mixing bee bread into the diet. We're not exactly sure how the worker and drone larvae use that pollen as they develop. We know, for example, in our lab, we can rear worker honeybees on diets completely devoid of bee bread. We know it's not 100% necessary, yet we know worker bees mix it into the diet of those larvae as those larvae are in their latter stages of development. Regardless, pollen is very important for bees to convert into bee bread so they have that source of proteins, vitamins, minerals, nutrients, lipids to keep that colony strong and healthy. The complete absence of pollen in the environment, the complete absence of bee bread in the colony means that colony is going to be unable to rear brood. And pollen deficient workers are smaller, have shorter lifespans, etc. Pollen is very important to the overall health and function of the colony. We, of course, always assign the behavior of bees collecting pollen to the production of fruits, vegetables, nuts, and berries, but it's also important to the production of strong, functioning honeybee colonies.